everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful morning so far. I wanted to hop on and ask you this. How do you know if the decision that you are making is of God or not in your personal life? In other words, how do you hear God's voice over a situation where it's not black or white what you should be doing in the Bible? Now, you know, there are a lot of scenarios that are very clearly defined for us in the Bible. And in those circumstances, we need to go with what the Bible has to say. Okay, but there are some things in our lives that are a little bit more vague where we need to hear the voice of God over our situation, and it's not clearly pointed out in the Bible. For example, God, which job should I take? You know, maybe you're faced with several different job options and you're praying about which one is the right fit. Maybe you're praying about, you know, God, should I still stay in work or should I stay home with my family? Maybe you're a stay-at-home mom, for example, stay-at-home dad. That can happen occasionally too, you know, and you're kind of praying for direction on that kind of stuff. You know, it could be regarding relationships. God, is this a person that I am supposed to be in relationship with right now or not? You know, there's a thousand different scenarios. I don't have time to get into all of those. But just to tell you that there are a lot of times where we truly need to hear God's voice over a situation in our personal lives, and He wants to talk to you. But so many people think that He's going to come in this booming, audible voice in those circumstances. And so often, you know, a lot of the time He's not. God's voice is a still, small voice over your circumstance. And so I want this to be really short and really practical today. And I want to give you guys a couple of tips that I use from the Bible to kind of guide my decision-making skills in my personal life when being led by the voice of God. And they're really simple and they're really practical. So hopefully this will help a little bit when we're talking about hearing the voice of God. Okay, so there are two primary scriptures that I want us to focus on today, okay? The first one is Philippians 4:7, and it says, "And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." Okay, let me tell you guys one of the number one tips that I use in my personal life to see whether or not God is on a particular situation. Do you feel a lack of peace over that thing? I'm gonna say it again. Do you feel a lack of peace over that situation? You know, you will experience this, and I've had friends who I have talked to before they made major decisions in their life, and they knew in their gut whether or not God was calling them to that thing, because they would either feel a complete peace in the midst of, you know, circumstances that looked like things were, you know, really off, quote unquote, or they would feel a lack of peace in circumstances that looked right. And they would move based on their senses and what they thought was best in the natural. And sure enough, they would end up in a huge mess down the line in their personal lives because they didn't listen to peace. Ladies and gents, if you allow peace to help to, I'm not saying we rely on this alone, but if you allow it to help you to call the shots in your life, I want to tell you guys, you're going to be in a much better place. This scripture that we just read said that peace acts as a guard in our personal lives. And so I know for me that if my peace is being disturbed, if there's an unsettledness in my spirit regarding a decision that I'm about to make or moving forward on something, that kind of sets off alarm bells in my brain that something is not right. You know, I've even had this in like really practical examples. I've had a lack of peace at jobs in the past before where I knew that that's not where God had called me. And then I've had total peace in different circumstances, even hard circumstances sometimes, or in the natural, it might have looked like I should have noped out, and I knew that I was exactly where God wanted me in that circumstance, ladies and gents. And so we can't just be led by emotions, but this is not just emotions, ladies and gents, that we're talking about. The peace of God guards your heart and your mind. You know, the Bible talks about how the heart is deceptive above all things. If we are just led by our emotions, you could follow lust instead of love. If we are just led by our emotions, you could follow greed instead of following God's path for your life. Insert whatever examples you want there. But that's why peace kind of acts as that guard, because when we start to walk in the wrong direction, Holy Spirit will start talking to you, okay? You know, that voice of God will kind of, that still small voice will say, something is not right. You're not feeling peace for a reason over this. I know it looks right in the natural, but this is really wrong for you. You know, a famous minister, John Bevere, talks about how he was going to sign a book deal one time. And everything in the natural, it looked like it was the right thing. It was a reputable company, XYZ, you know, there didn't look like there was anything wrong with it. And both his wife and God were talking to him, and they were saying, don't sign this. Don't go forward with this. And he moved forward with it anyway, despite the lack of peace that he was feeling in his spirit, despite hearing the no, quote unquote, from God, just because it looked right in the natural, even though his spirit was telling him, take a step back, don't move forward with this, it's going to really mess you up. And sure enough, he got himself in quite the mess. It turned out this publisher did some very sketchy things, you know, XYZ, and it all came out into the light after the fact. And if he had just listened to the voice of God, and he tells a story, he was like, man, if I had just listened to that piece, you know, I wouldn't have gotten myself into this mess. And so we have to have spiritual eyes, not just focus on what we see in the natural, ladies and gents. And a lack of peace is often a sign to you that you need to get in your prayer closet and say, God, I need direction over this. Show me the direction that I'm supposed to go. And, you know, there will be times in your life where God calls you to decisions that may not make sense to the people around you. You know, I've had one of those in my life in the last couple of years where God told me to make a decision that upset a lot of people, you know, because it seemed so out of the box. Now, it didn't disalign with scripture. It was totally, you know, scriptural what I was doing. But it was a decision that people just didn't understand in the natural, you know. And I knew that I was being totally obedient to God in that moment, but it shook some people up in my life, you know. And, you know, it's not to say, all of that to say, ladies and gents, God will sometimes call you to hard things. He will call you to things that don't make a lot of sense to you or others in the natural sometimes. But it's so important that you are obedient when you hear the voice of the Lord, because it will always work out for your good in the end, okay? The other thing that I want to rely on is this scripture. This is Psalm 37:4. Super simple, super practical today. It says, delight yourself also in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Now, there's a couple of things with this before you can just dive into this, because we've got to have this in context, okay? The first thing is, if you have a desire that does not align with scripture, that did not come from God. We have always got to put things through the scripture test. So if you have a desire to go steal a sweet little old lady's purse off the sidewalk because you want money, that did not come from God, okay? Because it's unscriptural. The Bible talks about you do not steal, okay? All right, so that's a very, very simple thing. The other thing is, you know, scripture also talks about seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Then all of these things shall be added unto you. So your discerner can get really off in this area. Your desires can be really off when you are not seeking God first and foremost in your personal life. Therefore, you can't trust it as much, okay? However, if you are putting God first in your personal life, if you are chasing after him with every ounce of your being, and there's a desire on your heart, often that's God, especially if you run it by the scripture test and, you know, you've got a peace about it, you're not feeling agitated about it, often that is God leading you in that direction, ladies and gents. You know, I cannot tell you the number of times in my life where God would suddenly change a desire when I was seeking him first. You know, suddenly I would feel like I'm not supposed to live in this town anymore. I've had God do this to me before, where it was like a flip that went off in my head in a relatively short amount of time. It's like 1 week I was completely content. The next week, you know, I didn't want to be there anymore. I was feeling a lack of peace over the situation. It's because Holy Spirit is leading you into that next season, ladies and gents. And so you've got to be really careful. But, you know, God loves you. He wants the desires of your heart to be fulfilled. And when you're seeking him first, often he's putting those desires on your heart. But you can't trust this area as much when you're far away from God and when you're not putting him first, because often you're going to be chasing after lust rather than chasing after, you know, the spirit things. You're going to be chasing after that flesh rather than chasing after the heart of God. So this one only works, the desires of your heart, if you feel peace, if it aligns with scripture, and also if you are really seeking God first in your personal life. This is really, really critical, ladies and gents, that you are putting him first. And then when you've got all of those components together, that's when you can step out in faith and say, God, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure I'm hearing your voice on this. And 9 times out of 10, probably you're going to be walking in the will of God. Not always. I'm not saying that just as a blanket statement, but these are things in scripture that can help to guide our decision making as we are moving forward. And of course, getting in your prayer closet. You know, God wants to confirm these things to you. He wants to help you. When you are making decisions like this, ladies and gents, he cares more than you could ever know about these things. So I want to encourage you today, follow peace. That's a big one. Do the scripture test. Does that decision line up with scripture? Does it go against scripture? And ask yourself this question. Am I really putting God first in my life? And you guys would know the answer to that. Some of you guys are going to feel convicted immediately when I ask you that question. Some of you guys are going to be like, yeah, for the first time in my life, I'm there. I am chasing after God first. And so listen to me. If you want the God dreams for your life, if you want the biggest and best blessings, and this is not why we serve him, but, you know, we serve him because we love him, right? But if you want those things for your life, if you want exceedingly and abundantly, quit focusing on the blessings. Quit focusing on getting all of these things for yourself. Focus on putting God first, then your desires will align with God's will for your life, and then you'll be able to see clearly and step out on what he has for you. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll chat with you again soon.